Hey everybody, I'm here at the University of Florida's Innovation Hub. I am here with the CEO of Botanica Testing Corporation. And the reason I'm here in the laboratory with these amazing researchers and scientists, and we're going to talk all about that in just a minute, is because many of you have been asking really important questions. We're going to talk about CBD today. We're going to talk about CBD testing, how it's done, why it's important, and if you're going to buy a CBD product, what you need to look for. So, yeah. Adam, thank you so much for having us.
Yeah, absolutely.
Really excited to just learn a little bit about why you built this company, why it's one of the best in the whole country, yeah. And what you do differently. So first sure. and foremost, what, why?
Well, so we started off, on the pharma side as well as natural products and flavor and fragrances, and mostly studying essential oils and plant botanicals and extracts. Mm-hmm. And because of our background, some people came to us and basically asked, you do all of these other plants, you do like 131 other plants, can you do hemp? Mm-hmm. And so we basically said, yeah, we can try that. We can start doing that. And so, that's how we kind of formed the company, kind of worked it out of the way that we were already doing it in the lab, and basically decided to specialize this company on all the testing that you have to do in the cannabis space. And so that's really what we've been doing now since for almost a year.
So you test cannabis, mm-hmm. and you test hemp.
Yes. So this facility is specific to CBD and hemp. And so the only products that come in this specific location would be your low THC hemp products.
So the low THC hemp products, yep. You get thousands and thousands of companies probably mm-hmm. shipping you product all the time to test.
Yep.
Are you surprised at how many of them don't pass?
Well, the first thing that we're kind of looking for that most people want to know is, the product that we manufacture, the product that we have, does it actually meet the label claim? And mm-hmm. so in this industry, kind of standard is within 10% higher or lower. Of what you're putting on the label, it needs to be in that range. Most people want it to be over because they want to see more CBD than they do, mm-hmm. less CBD than the label. And so the problem is that, with how new the industry is, how difficult it is to do the manufacturing, and just some of the nuances of it, the ability to actually meet label claim is very difficult. And so we see probably, well over half of the products that come in that people believe are a certain concentration don't actually meet that concentration within 10%.
So they're lower.
It could be lower or higher.
Got
so
it.
The times we see products that don't have any CBD in them at all, even though
wow.
they're supposed to be around 500 milligrams or more. And so we've seen stuff that's 3 to 4 times over. We've seen stuff that is, there's nothing there. And the way that we kind of think about it is, if somebody's buying this off the shelf and they're using it every single day, expecting to get a certain effect, we're expecting CBD to have some sort of workaround in the body. The problem is that if you're getting something you think is 500 milligrams and it actually is 20, mm-hmm. big and drastic difference.
And then you're going to be wondering, you spend all that money and
exactly.
also you're not getting the results, and you're wondering, well, maybe, CBD doesn't work. And I see a lot of those comments, mm-hmm. As people are intrigued and they want these benefits and they want to understand the endocannabinoid system, mm-hmm. and really how to activate it, not getting that right amount is a big deal. There's that JAMA study that shows that like 74% of the products that are developed don't meet the label mm-hmm. claims. So,
we see a lot of that.
Mm-hmm.
And so for us, a lot of it is, is somebody buying and getting mm-hmm. what they think they are getting?
Right.
Because if you're talking about a drug or you're talking about something else, like a vitamin, something like that, you're expecting to get exactly what you think that you're getting.
Yeah.
And if you're not getting that, then not only are you paying extra money for something that isn't there, but you also are, you could have side effects, you could have other things that happen to you, and you don't know what it's from. And so, like, for instance, here in Florida, on the medical side, as well as the CBD side, for 3+ years, there have been zero regulations as far as any kind of contamination testing that needs to be done.
Wow.
And so for the medical side, regulations were supposed to be put down 3 years ago for pesticides, heavy metals, basically everything like that. And at this point, we still don't have specs on what we're supposed to be testing for, how low we're supposed to be testing, or even what's safe for consumption.
That's really, really scary when you think about, the inadvertent
yeah.
results that can transpire. For me personally, just on a small side note, I use Chinese herbs to heal my autoimmune eczema, and it did an amazing job. Mm-hmm. But when I got tested years later, my heavy metal levels on five different counts were off the charts. And it was because of the way they were processed, because of where they were grown, because of the soil having the heavy metals. And you talk about pesticides, and pesticides negatively impact the endocannabinoid system. So you could be taking something and actually hurting yourself.
Yeah, and I mean, we've seen issues in other states. For instance, Illinois, there was some CBD products that had to be pulled off the shelves because three people died. Hundreds more ended up in emergency with internal bleeding from high arsenic levels. And so those are normal things that should be tested for, and anything that's being ingested. The problem is, if you don't have those regulations, you don't have those specs, it's not tested for, mm-hmm. and then the public can suffer.
Yeah, I think what I see with CBD that's so different mm-hmm. than any other nutrient. So for example, you know, I've been involved with resveratrol for over a decade, mm-hmm. turmeric, citrus mm-hmm. bergamot, all of these cacao, all of these amazing plants, but there are many, many years of safety testing. There's much research on how to extract mm-hmm. and these sort of things. With CBD and hemp and marijuana, it opens up a completely different world, right? And so you get a lot of people who don't have expertise in a particular industry mm-hmm. jumping in.
Yeah, and we see that a lot from the environmental side, the agro side, everything else like that. And so for us, we decided that as far as testing goes, we were gonna treat it more like a GLP pharma lab. And mm-hmm. so our chief scientific officer, his background, 25 years in pharma, GlaxoSmithKline, Bristol-Myers Squibb, and then also on the tobacco side with Lorillard Tobacco. So we decided we needed to bring the pharma expertise as well as the natural products mm-hmm. kind of tobacco side of it and flavors and fragrance into this. And then just kind of take what we already know from like the peppermint industry and other things and be able to do our testing on CBD in that way. Because with this industry being so new, most people are jumping in and saying, you know, we have to reinvent everything and we have to do everything brand new, as opposed to saying, yeah, there's a wheel, there's a system, there's procedures, there's things we've already done in all these other industries. We just need to take them and apply them to the CBD industry.
That's awesome. And kudos, you know, I get the opportunity to mm-hmm. visit with you quite often, and I'm always impressed by the standards, the quality of the team that you have here, you know, the methodologies that you use. My mm-hmm. father's a chemist. My first memories are in the lab, in laboratories like this. So just tell us a little bit about what you're testing for. I've got this, and we can talk about this. But tell us what you're testing for on this side of this room.
So in this specific building, or not building, but this room, what we have right here is an HPLC. And so that is for the cannabinoids. So CBD, THC, CBG, CBN, basically the top main 11 cannabinoids. So on the other side, we're testing for any volatile compounds, so flavors, fragrances, residual solvents, basically anything that can be heated and then turns into a vapor. And so a lot of that has to do with the basically anything you can taste, you can smell in your CBD product mm-hmm. would be a terpene test or a volatile compound test from the GC mass spec. And then the cannabinoid test would be basically just your 11 cannabinoids. Mm.
So how does someone who is taking CBD or wants to take CBD, how does someone know what to choose?
Sure, and a lot of that comes down to, you know, at this point, marketing. A lot of different strains.
But what's the real answer? You know, like what, you were online mm-hmm. and you were searching for a CBD product, what would you look for?
I enjoy gummies.
Okay, not to look racist, but like, would you be looking for the data, the supporting research, right?
For me, I mean, on any product, I first of all like to make sure that, you know, the correct testing has been done so it's safe to consume.
And how do you know that? Is it through the certificate of analysis?
Yeah, so most labs put out, and most companies, if they do it correctly, the first thing you need to check is if the company that you're buying a product from is actually doing the correct safety testing to begin with. Mm-hmm. If you can't find anything as far as results or any data whatsoever that they're willing to put out to the public, then I wouldn't buy from them.
Right.
The second thing is, once you do have that information, is it passing the specs it's supposed to be passing? Is it, fulfilling the requirements of the laws in individual states. Most states don't have them yet, but a lot of other states like California have put down certain regulations. For the individual customer, you know, the burden of responsibility shouldn't be on them. It's on the company. And so the company needs to be upfront and honest about what they have, what the data supports, and then what they have as a final product and they're selling to you.
That's great. Thank you so much for your time. This is awesome, and I'm looking forward to talking to you more.